We want to find all the zeros of the polynomial function and then write the polynomial as a product of linear factors. So for a quick review, from the complex factorization theorem, a degree n polynomial function has exactly n complex zeros as long as we count multiplicity. So if we find all the complex zeros, then we can write the polynomial function as a product of linear factors as we see here, where the r's would be the zeros of the polynomial and the exponents m would be the multiplicity, and a would be the leading coefficient. So going back to our example, we want to start by finding the real rational zeros of the polynomial function. To do this, we could use trial and error using the rational roots theorem, which states that the rational roots must come from the list of the ratio of the factors of the constant term to the factors of the leading coefficient. So in this case, we could make a list of the factors of positive 6 over the factors of positive 1. But instead of doing this, we're going to graph the function and see if we can find any real rational zeros as x-intercepts. So if we graph this function, notice how there are 3 x-intercepts, which tells us that we do have 3 real zeros, but only one of them, this one here at x equals negative 1, looks like it's guaranteed that it will be real and rational. So this point here is the point negative 1, 0. Notice how when x equals negative 1, the y value or the function value would be 0, verifying x equals negative 1 is a 0. So if we're keeping a list of our zeros, we now know that x equals negative 1 is one of the 3 zeros that we're looking for. And because we have a 0, we also have one of the 3 linear factors that we need to write this degree 3 polynomial as a product of linear factors. We now know that p of x must contain one factor of x plus 1 if x equals negative 1 is a 0. And the remaining factor here would still be a degree 2 factor, but we're going to find this and then find the zeros of this factor separately. So what we'll do now is divide the polynomial function by x plus 1. So we want to take x cubed minus 5x squared plus 6 and divide this by what we know to be a factor of x plus 1. And the quotient here should be a degree 2 factor. And let's divide this using synthetic division. But we do have to be careful because there's no x term here, so we do have to include a plus 0x term. So to perform synthetic division or divide by x plus 1, we'll use the constant negative 1, and then we'll list the coefficients, which are 1 for 1x cubed, negative 5 for negative 5x squared. Again, there's no x terms, so we need a 0 here for 0x, and then the constant 6. So now we'll bring the 1 down to start and start multiplying by negative 1. Negative 1 times 1 is negative 1, and we add, that's negative 6. Negative 1 times negative 6 is 6, and we add, that's 6. And negative 1 times 6 is negative 6, and we add, and that's 0. So notice how the remainder is 0. This represents a degree 2 quotient of 1x squared minus 6x plus 6, which would go here, which means our polynomial function is a product of x plus 1 and x squared minus 6x plus 6. But now we need to find the values of x that would make this factor equal to 0, but this doesn't factor, so we'll have to solve this using the quadratic formula. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So again, our goal here is to find the zeros of x squared minus 6x plus 6, and then we'll use those zeros to write this as a product of 2 linear factors. So using the quadratic formula, notice that a is equal to 1, b is equal to negative 6, and c is equal to 6. So we'll have x equals negative b, or negative negative 6, plus or minus the square root of b squared, that's negative 6 squared, minus 4 times a times c, or 4 times 1 times 6, divided by 2 times a, or 2 times 1. Let's begin to simplify. This would be positive 6, and then plus or minus the square root of, this would be 36 minus 24, that's 12, divided by 2, Well, the square root of 12 is equal to the square root of 4 times 3. The square root of 4 is 2. So this is equal to 6 plus or minus 2 square root 3 divided by 2. Let's be careful simplifying here. We'll break this up into two fractions of 6 divided by 2 plus or minus 2 square root 3 divided by 2. That would give us 3 plus or minus square root 3. This simplifies the 3, and these two simplify out. So these are the two remaining zeros. So if I go back to the previous slide, the other two zeros are x equals 3 plus square root 3 and x equals 3 minus square root 3. And now we can use these last two zeros to write x squared minus 6x plus 6 as two linear factors. We would have p of x equals x plus 1 times the quantity x minus 3 plus square root 3 times the quantity x minus 3 minus square root 3. So we've answered both questions. We found all the zeros. We have three real zeros. One's real and rational, this one, and these two are real but irrational. And we also wrote the polynomial function as a product of three linear factors, as we see here. I hope you found this helpful.